Very well. Where can I find them?
At the border to the Heartland, near the Whisper Wood. They will be waiting for you there. Take the Myret, talk to Signet Master Bartar, and hand him this package. And then follow his orders. Ah, one more thing. It might be self-evident, but keep your knowledge about the death of the Lightborn to yourself.
Right.
I do not believe you can do any real harm. But in the worst case, path-abiding people will consider you a heretic. After the cycle has been stopped, we will deliberate upon how we deal with the matter. If and how we tell our people about it. But not now, that is for sure. Now, leave. The sooner we can dispense with this formality, the better.
Part 2. Meet Signet Leader Jorek Bartar and two novices at the Heartland's border.
Walk blessed, prophetess.
You were imprisoned for a very long time, weren't you? 30 years?
Yes. Why do you ask?
Where were you kept prisoner?
In an old temple in the northern mountains of Nerim. It was a bastion of our order before Narazul's armies conquered it after the Battle of Triomar. Ironic, I know.
I can't imagine 30 years of imprisonment didn't leave any scars. Why am I asking him about scars?
They did. What are you getting at?
Well, you want me to trust in your leadership. It's only fair that I learn more about you as a person. It's awfully personal, though.
A fair point. But in the future, just be upfront. I do not like such veiled remarks.
I don't blame you.
So, yes, my time in the prison was harsh. The hunger, the degradation, to name the most obvious. The worst, however, was the isolation. Ironically enough, that was the last thing I had expected, you know. From all the suffering there is, it seems so banal. But it isn't. You either find ways to cope with it, or it breaks you. Fortunately, I managed to do the former. For me, it was memories of the time before my incarceration, the prospect of what would come after it. They were my window into the outer world, so to speak. They reminded me that I was more than this deprived creature I had become in those dungeons.
Figures. Yeah, that makes sense. How did it feel to be free again?
Strange. Everything seemed too bright, too unreal.
Can't imagine 30 years.
I especially felt that in the cloister with Narazul's mages. I had difficulty talking to other people. And whenever I did, it felt as if the others were like wax figures. Like some cruel joke put in front of my eyes in order to mock me.
What's it like now?
Better. Our mission, my responsibility here as a leader, it has helped me to find my way back into the real world.
Actually, I'm surprised you went straight back to the Order after all that has happened. That's a lot of responsibility to take on after such trauma.
What would have been the alternative? A life as a fisherman? If the things I had to live through taught me one thing, then it was how important it is for me to be right here, right now, doing what I do. In fact, this is precisely what is missing in the world. People who do not let the whims of fate break their resolve. Now, enough of this. We have business to attend to.
But about the cycle.
Yes.
Could you tell me more about us emissaries? What defines us?
That depends on whom you ask. In some writings of the Pyreans, we are referred to as chosen ones. But this is wrong. A better word would be chess figures with their own will. Whatever force causes the cycle also gave us powers and a task. But fulfilling that task is our own responsibility.
And what exactly are these tasks that we have?
Well, that is something else we only know in broad strokes. It is my task to lead mankind in its battle against the cleansing, to rally our strengths, so to speak. Yours is to read the Echo and help us gain the knowledge we need for victory. How exactly you're going to do that is something we still have to find out.
Read the Echo. So is that why I know the future by knowing the past? Because the past echoes into the future? So you have no idea as to why we were chosen?
No.
Short and to the point. Apart from us, are there other emissaries?
I do not know. But there are hints. We will see.
Do you have any idea how long the cycle has been going on?
Good question. In their writing, the Pyreans say it has existed for aeons. Since this world exists, since the Sea of Eventualities exists, so too then does the cycle. It seems to be a part of existence, so to speak.
So wait, this Sea of Eventualities. If I'm onto something, guys, don't tell me. Or if I'm not, don't tell me. No spoilers, no hints. Just saying, thinking out loud. The Sea of Eventualities. We bring in things from other realities to change our reality. So we'll have a tree standing in the middle of a glade. And we'll make that tree set on fire by bringing in a tree from another eventuality that is on fire. Something to that effect. So, let's say humanity is going to end, but we'll bring in, this will require a lot of magic, probably a lot of mages all working together, to bring in an eventuality where mankind does not end. And thus, mankind does not end. All I have to do is find out an eventuality where that happens and have enough power to be able to basically put that over the entire world, or at least the 4 or 5 continents that we know of. Just a thought. No one has ever succeeded in breaking the pattern. That's pretty discouraging.
The Pyreans didn't, and neither did the dozen civilizations that came before them. That is what we know. But as for what happened before that, our knowledge about the past is limited. All that matters for now is that the cycle threatens us, and that we have to stop it.
Aren't there more options?
That, a better word would be, chess figures with their own will. Whatever force causes the cycle also gave us powers and a task. But fulfilling that task is our own responsibility. Yes?
Here it is. Yeah, these visions I have, the echo of the future, how exactly does it work?
As I said before, my knowledge about that is limited. But if it helps you, imagine that it is a way of perceiving that which connects us all, our subconscious.
You mean the place your dreams come from? The collective subconscious of mankind?
Yes. You know, most people perceive themselves as an entity separate from the rest of the world. And while this is partially true, there is something that connects us. Dark corners of our mind. Bridges to which we in a conscious state do not have access to. But you do not need to be supernaturally gifted to feel that these bridges exist. I am sure you have experienced it yourself at one time or another. A moment where you knew exactly what another person thought or would do next.
Right.
People with close blood ties can especially feel that connection. Children and their mothers, siblings, and especially twins.
Well, It's more like because they know each other very well. And, possibly have things in common as well. Especially twins. But you're saying that all humans are connected.
Correct. And while most people hardly feel this connection at all, as if looking through a tinted window, to you, it is wide open during your visions.
If that's the case, how do you explain that I can see memories of the Pyreans, too? They have been dead for millennia. I see memories of the Pyreans? What memory was from the Pyreans?
Their bodies might be, but the traces they left behind still remain. Everything that was, everything that is, and everything that will be, it already exists in the sea of eventualities.
Right.
This is the basic principle of magic. And time. Time is not a straight line. Only the barriers of our mind make us perceive it as such. Visions, premonitions, dreams that become reality. These are all leftovers of waves from other eventualities that spill over into our reality. There have always been people able to read them, but none so good at it as you are, thanks to the Echo.
The Echo. Hi. Thanks, Taylor. Walk blessed and all that stuff. I learned of two things. The world awaits an event called the Cleansing, in which a whole civilization, ours, will disappear without a trace if we won't stop it. Also, it seems that I am a messenger, people who play a decisive role in the fight against the Cleansing. That is why Aranthiel wants me to formally join the Order by taking the same examination which novices of the Order have to take. I have to meet Signet Leader Jotek Bartar at the border of the Heartland. Alright. Dust maggot pickles? Oof. Just taking a look at this stuff. That was very tough, and this apparently is just as tough. And this stuff is tough. Alright, yeah, let's head for this then. I can just go to the Myrid Tower. Border of the Heartland. Taylor? Yeah, I hope he knows what he's doing, too. So if we go to the south quarter, find one of these fences and go to the south quarter. These magical
transpire and burst 80 100 times. The sky can rain fire. It just does never change.
No, huh? We need to find one of these magical signpost things.
Yes.
Yes. Have I even been in here? Hold on. Not sure if I've been in this one. Patrolman Rufus.
We always go too easy on the scum.
I think I've been here already. Yeah, this goes out to Barracord. I came in from the other way. I think. Yeah. Let me just see where this goes, because I want South Quarter. Like, Foreign Quarter. Ah. I think it says Southern Quarter for some reason here. Southern Quarter, Marriott Tower. Now just don't tell this guy we want to look for the island. He'll be transported there and brutally killed.
Walk blast.
I'm running blast. Even better. I can't get up from this way, can I? I have to go up that way. Hi.
Walk blessed, friend. Where are you headed?
Yeah, don't choose this. Myrids?
How about Myrids? In the time before the Blood Moon Revolt, a long time ago, tame Myrids like this one here was a really rare sight. Nowadays, though, they're pretty common. At least here in Enderal. Pity, somehow.
Thought we talked about this. We probably did. Why pity?
Ah, I guess that sounds stupid, but I sometimes long for the times my grandfather...
Yeah.
Nowadays, well, you can guess. Riding a Myrid has become as ordinary as riding a mule. But, who am I to complain?
How do Myrids know where to go?
Oh, well, and through those clicking sounds, I also tell them where you want to go.
I need a flight. Before...
Sure, where to?
Border of the Heartland. I wonder what this test entails. You have to fight something incredibly hard. Or do I just need my number two pencil? And a sheet where you fill in the bubbles. Location discovered. Hi. Whoop. Just gonna take a look up here. Ooh, teleport to Art. Well, I can just take it. This is free for travelers. I can go that way. They're just hanging out waiting for me over there, apparently. I'm trying to get up here. Pardon me, I'm a very confused person. I can go this way. Oof. They're waiting right there. Oh. I'm gonna be stuck on stuff. Boop! Back here.
Yes.
Grandmaster Aranthiel sent me. I'm supposed to take the trial to become a keeper?
Oh, yes. You're the prodigy. I was expecting something else. I hope you're aware
something?
Of what you're getting yourself into. Our novices train for years for this trial. And as much as I respect the Grandmaster, I think this is naive.
I have no idea what
I'm
getting myself into.
In other words, it will be dangerous. Be aware of that.
Barely. The way the Grandmaster put it, I don't seem to have much of a choice if we want to keep on living.
How selfless of you! But as you wish.
Thanks.
Then it seems I'm granted the extraordinary honor of exalting the first pathless in the history of the Order to a keeper. The others will scream for joy.
I hope not.
Give me the package the Grandmaster gave you, and say hello to your new comrades.
Oh.
I have to go prepare something.
I didn't even look at it. Package for Signet. Package for Signet Leader removed. Talk to the other examinees.
What is it? Talk to Kalir and Dunwar. I will be with you in a second.
Nope, that wasn't a book that I could have read. I also have a treasure map. I kept forgetting to look at it. I don't know if that would be here. Yes, it would be here. Okay. Temple Arc X. Got it. I lose the cursor when I do that. Hello. Kalia?
What? Oh, hello. You're our unexpected addition, aren't you? The prodigy?
Yes, but call me Topaz. Sounds less awkward.
It does, actually. I'm Kalia Sakarish. By my path, novice and aspirant to the first sigil.
Kalia.
I've been told what you did in Old Rationgrad. That you saved the excavations and fought back the mercenaries all on your own. An astonishing feat, truly. You have my respect for that.
Oh, thank you. It probably wasn't as glorious as you picture it. Those bastards deserved it.
Maybe, yes. Sometimes death is the only logical consequence of our actions.
She dislikes
that. I'm really curious as to what the mercenaries thought they were doing. Someone willing to attack the Holy Order is either extremely powerful or extremely naive.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's been an honor to meet you in person. Let's talk later.
I see we're back on equal ground. She liked and didn't dislike something. Okay. Dunwar.
I don't want to hear it.
I was thinking the exact same thing before the words popped up. I beg your pardon.
You're prattling. I don't want to hear it. Just shove off.
I don't prattle. What's your problem?
You have to ask. This country is going downhill, and you are living proof of it, my friend. First, Nevermi's wild mages are allowed to walk on the holy temple grounds as if it were some kind of brothel. Mercenaries are hired, and now you, an outlander, a pathless, are able to be initiated into the sigils of the Holy Order.
Oh.
We've trained for years to stand here, and until now, I thought that this country respected its traditions. That's my problem. Now get out of my sight.
I thought the wild mage was supposed
right,
to be out on the pathless.
Come here. These potions will be necessary later, so be careful with them. Apart from that, it's still a few miles to the ritual place. As you're all gifted with magic, the spores in the forest ahead will make you a little dizzy, but we won't stay for long. Any questions?
Oh. Yeah, the spore things. What spores are you talking about exactly? You're talking about those crystal glowing things?
Long story. Simply put, they come from a special kind of mushroom that has infested this forest, and staying near them worsens the Arcanist's fever.
Yeah, you've come across
so, them. In case you're thinking about exploring further, take some magical protection and some ambrosia with you.
Do you have some? Blessing of the Wise One, rank 2 added to the spellbook. Alright. Alright, then let's go.
Good. Stay close to me.
Strange potion. I only have 2 ambrosia. Follow Signet Leader Jorek Bartar to the right place. It's the right place, get it? My arcane fever already is not doing very well. What's the strange potion? Doesn't show up. Strange potion shows up in clutter, of all places. Is that supposed to help with the arcane fever? It looks like this. Oh, I have to get rid of that. It's a different bottle than that of ambrosia. He said it was a healing potion, didn't he? What's this potion? What'd I do? You've entered command state. I was clicking on him to try to talk to him. To issue a command to your follower, move the reticle until the command appears. Then press control to give that order. I think that's not really...
But it's too late for that now. Korek would have conquered the city. Instead, you will be ashamed.
What?
So this is the Whispering Forest. Fascinating. I've read a lot about it, but never actually seen it.
Poor thing. My brothers and I have seen the border countless many times before. But I bet you know all about the Undercity's stead.
Well, I really don't like that guy.
Not now.
Okay.
Huh?
I just had another vision, just now.
Oh, did you now? So, what did you see? A horde of naked Skarrag women charging towards us?
Nothing quite so fortunate,
Okay, look. You're very impressive and talented, I get it. But please, spare me this rubbish about visions and echoes of the future.
It's real, man.
Tialor always had a fondness for those kind of things, but I'm not really one for all that. So... let's keep going.
What is this over here? Glimmer dust here.
Keep walking.
Oh!
More of them!
Oh my god, man. Cane fever is really bad right now. Hold up, hold up, hold up.
More of them.
Bug eggs.
Focus, come here. Focus.
Well, I can't summon in combat. It could have told me I needed a lot of ambrosia coming out here.
Wait, do you see that?
What?
Yes, that man. What is he doing?
Who cares? He's probably just a traveler.
Is he digging something?
He shouldn't be here. No merchant in his right mind would voluntarily travel through the Whispering Forest. We'll go take a look at him. Stay ready.
So he's mining or digging something? You there!
She's with me now. Forever.
What?
Kirosh!
What in? You there! Who are you? And what are you doing here?
Dead donkey.
She's with me now. Forever.
What are you, deaf? Identify yourself!
His eyes. Master, this is the Red Madness.
Shit, of course. You will put away that pickaxe right now, my sir, and then get on your knees.
She wanted to leave. Don't you understand?
Oh, brother.
She wanted to leave me. Just like that.
This is disgusting.
She will stay.
By the righteous path!
Thanks.
Have you lost your mind?
I could ask you the same thing, dammit. Did you forget what Magister Yarrow did to the novices? This man could have attacked us at any moment.
Oh, really? Malphus, protect us from your cunning. But did the thought ever cross your mind that one needs to understand a disease in order to heal it? And that some apothecary might have given their left hand for a living patient?
This... you're not being fair, Master. I was only protecting us.
Like heck you did. You behaved like an idiot. And not for the first time.
He's
the
got
other
a
masters
point, you know.
Might ignore that fact due to your religious commitment and your bloodline. I get that. But if something like this ever happens again, you will be suspended from the rites and will spend the rest of your life polishing prayer banks in the sanctum. Do I make myself clear?
He really was trying to protect us, Master. Maybe...
Do I make myself clear?
Don't stick up for him. He's a jerk.
You do, Master. And I beg your forgiveness for my offense.
Granted. Now let's push on. We will take care of the body after the ritual.
Are you okay?
Just save it.
Not now.
Now, baby.
Keep walking.
What's this? Rallada Shara. Does that mean glimmer cap dust? Got some glimmer cap dust, y'all. Ooh. What's up there? Can I look up here? Something's going on up here. Oh, wow. Oh! Don't do that. Are you guys headed for that stairs? It looks like we could be headed for this structure. Looks pretty interesting. I think I was right, though. We fight stuff. That's our test, right?
Here it is. The first foothold.
The first foothold.
This is where Malphus's vassals erected their first camp. So behave yourselves accordingly. You too, prodigy.
Do I have to? Why?
Well then, before we start, there's something I need to tell you.
I can't move.
Something important.
I can only turn.
The rumors concerning the deaths of the Lightborn, they're true.
What? Thought we weren't supposed to say anything about that.
The gods are dead. They fell 2 winters ago beneath the sword of an unknown traveler. We, that is, the Order, have known about this for quite some time now, but haven't told the common people yet. But since the three of you intend to take the trial, there's no way to disguise the truth anymore.
But how can a god die?
There was a prophecy, as old as the Lightborn themselves, in which there was talk of a shadow god who would end the era of gods. And it came true. I'm sorry.
Shadow god?
You're sorry. You're telling us that the gods have been killed, and you are sorry. What's next? That tomorrow the sun will stop shining?
It's not his fault.
Tell us that this is a test, Master. It is, isn't it? A test of our faith.
Get a grip on yourself.
No, the Lightborn are dead. But hard as it may be to accept, we cannot afford to fall into a spiritual crisis right now.
The Order of the Gods, Malphus's order, was created to protect the Lightborn. And if what you're saying, this blasphemy is true, then we're meaningless. We failed, don't you see that?
God, cope, will ya?
Oh, by the Black Guardian, I just can't believe it.
He's falling apart.
Thou shalt be seen, thou shalt live by my virtue. Third Revelation, verse 137.
Okay, Hermione.
I know it's hard, Dunmar, but if this is true, we have to show strength and keep on believing in what the Lightborn stood for.
Yeah, listen to her.
Which is the idea of peace and...
Oh, just shut your mouth, Sakharesh. If anything, you lowborn scum are living proof that the Order is going downhill.
Oh, nice.
Do you really think I don't know about the village? You're a damned witch, and if this were the old times, you would have been crucified long time ago.
You don't mean that, Dunmar.
He really said that.
Drop it, for heaven's
sake. She stood up for you.
We're all on the same side here.
No.
Are we?
We are not. This wench doesn't have any right to wear the white robes. And if you would spend more time with the Holy Scriptures instead of your brandy bottle, you would see it as well.
Take him down.
But no.
He had one more chance, and that's it.
I swear to you, one more word and you will wish that I just suspended you.
He had one chance,
but
that's it.
No buts. Do you understand?
Yes.
You gotta get rid of him.
I hope so, for your sake. Just be glad that this is a time when we need skilled mages more than ever. Just be glad.
Well, we'd chop your head off,
now,
mister.
Now enough of this. Our demeanor defiles this sacred place. There will be enough time for depression and personal crisis after the trial. Let's recite the holy words.
I don't know the holy words.
Thou art my light, my glimmer at the horizon. Thy name is my sacrament, and thy path I will honor. In life, as in death.
May your light guide me.
May your light guide me.
Good. As you know, this trial will test the fortitude of your spirit. Because this is what distinguishes a keeper from a soldier. What distinguishes a wise man from a fool. Keep that in mind.
He's failing this guy.
Now, drink the potion I gave you.
All right.
You first, prodigy. Let's hope the Grand Master was right about you.
I don't want to drink it. Okay, I'm drinking it. Oh! God damn it!